الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد آخر الأنبياء في الدنيا عصرا وأجلهم يوم القيامة شأنا وذكرا، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, today I wanted to share with you a hadith that has really touched me through the course of my life. And a hadith, inshallah ta'ala, that really represents and shows how the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was comprehensive in his speech. But he would say his words in a very small constructed sentences, but it would have a very vast and strong meaning. As he said about himself, "Utitu jawami' al-kalim," I was given the comprehensive speech. And wallahi, he was alayhi salatu wassalam. There's a hadith which Al-Imam Hafiz Ibn Rajab rahimahullah, he brought in his kitab Jami' Ulum wal-Hikam, hadith 18. That is the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And this hadith in its original essence is in Sunan al-Tirmidhi. And Imam al-Tirmidhi rahimahullah, he narrated it من طريق سفيان الثوري رحمه الله, who narrated from Habib ibn Abi Thabit, who narrated from Maymun ibn Abi Shabib, who then narrated from Abi Dhar رضي الله تعالى عنه, that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, اتق الله حيثما كنت وأتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحوها وخالق الناس بخلق حسن. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started by saying, اتق الله حيث ما كنت. The Prophet said, be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever you are. Taqwa. Have a taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was narrated that Ali ibn Abi Talib said, when he explained what taqwa meant, he said, التقوى means العمل بالتنزيل, is to implement the Quran and the Sunnah. العمل بالتنزيل والرضا بالقليل, and is to be pleased with the minimum. والرضا بالقليل واستعداد ليوم الرحيل, and is to prepare for the day which you're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me repeat one more time what he said. He said, العمل بالتنزيل والرضا بالقليل واستعداد ليوم الرحيل. This shows us that the Sahabas understood taqwa, what it meant. Talq ibn Habib and others, they explained it in other meanings and any other different definitions that it holds. The people of taqwa are those who Allah tabarak wa ta'ala promised Jannah for them. تِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي نُورِثُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا مَنْ كَانَ تَقِيًّا. Here it is, Jannah is prepared and it's for the people who come with taqwa. In that same surah, Surah Maryam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَإِنْ مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا كَانَ عَلَى رَبِّكَ حَتْمًا مَقَضِيًّا ثُمَّ نُنَجِّي الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَنَذَرُ الظَّالِمِينَ فِيهَا جِثِيًّا. Allah promises us that every single person is going to go over the hellfire. But there's a group of people who are going to make it through. A group of people are going to be saved from falling into the hellfire. Allah said, ثُمَّ نُنَجِّي الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا. The people who are going to be saved are those who come with taqwa. So the hadith that I started my reminder with, which is, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتِ. Fear Allah and be conscious of Him wherever you are. That part of the hadith is what the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has stated. And here you can all see me today. I'm out there in the open. I'm in a place where you can see all of London. But it reminded me that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is over us. And He sees us subhanahu wa ta'ala, every movement that we do. And that wherever we are, He subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to see us. And He's going to account us for it. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنُ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. He knows the deceiving eye, what it's doing. And He also knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that which is in our chests. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala deserves that we fear Him and that we are conscious of Him and that whatever we do, He's going to hold us account for it the day of judgment. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ. The day when children and wealth are not going to benefit you. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Except the person who comes to Allah with a pure heart. And the taqwa, it resides in the heart. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, التقوى هاهنا, التقوى هاهنا, التقوى هاهنا, فأشار إلى صدري ثلاث مرات. The taqwa is here, the taqwa is here, the taqwa is here. And he pointed towards his chest three times, alayhi salatu wa salam. The second part of the hadith that I started with is وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا. And every crime and every mistake and every shortcoming that you do, follow it up with a good act. As Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ, that the righteous actions would eradicate the mistakes that you have done. So the second part of the hadith is telling us, you're bound to do mistakes as human beings. But what's needed from you and that which you should come with, my brothers and sisters, is follow it up with the righteous actions. Follow it up with something that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third part of the hadith is, وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا وَخَالِقِ النَّاسَ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ وَخَالِقِ النَّاسَ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ. Deal with the people in a good manner. Be a person who is of high morals and ethics, good etiquettes. And if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was told to have good characteristics with his own companions, what do you then think of yourself? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ فَاعْفُ عَنْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. If you were not a soft person with the companions and you didn't show them leniency, the Sahabas would disperse from your gathering, they would leave you. If you were a person who had bad manners, they would leave you. So the good manners is needed from every single person. Every single Muslim should have good manners and uphold that manners, my beloved brothers and sisters. Good akhlaq and good manners. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in a hadith, "Inna aqrabikum minni manzilan yawm al-qiyamati," the people who are the closest to me in status and closest to me the day of judgment, "ahsanukum akhlaqa," the ones who have the best characteristics. Have good manners. There's no excuse not to have good manners. The times when you're happy and the times when you're sad, the times when you're stressed and the times when you're going through good, always remember to have good manners and good etiquettes and the way you deal with people. If a person insults you and calls you by evil names, to remember to call them in good and to show good conduct, good behavior, good morals and good ethics. This is a sign that every Muslim should hold up to. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran. That being the case, my brothers and sisters, I conclude there. I just wanted to make it a benefit that we can all share from and that we can all take. This benefit is to myself and it's to each and every one of you. Anything which I have said that was wrong, the slip of a tongue, because it's not a topic I prepared, it's not a talk but it's something that just came to my mind and I thought I'd share it with you all, inshallah ta'ala. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.